deal with one of the important properties of functions called as recursion. Basically, till now, we have been seeing that a function can give a call to another function. Let's see example for illustrating the general way of calling these functions. Now, in this main function, I'm going to give a call to a function called as f1. So when I give a call to function f1, f1 goes to this particular path. Now, in this function, it might do a task. After doing a task, it will produce a result. Since it is a void function, it will not return any value, but the control comes back and goes with the main function. This is the traditional way of using these functions. Now, why don't we try out something new? In this, main gives a call to f1. Rather than f1 doing a task and coming back, let it do a task, but somewhere in the mid, what I'll do is, I'll give a call to a function called as f1 one more time. What happens when I call a function with the same title within the same function? In fact, this will give a call to itself. When a function gives a call to itself, we call this function as a recursive function, and the process is known as recursion. So here, when a function gives a call to itself, it means that, is it going to repeat this particular task again and again? Yes, it is going to repeat a task. Let's check out how exactly this particular recursion goes and what are the precautions which I'm supposed to take and what are the drawbacks of this particular feature called as recursion. So here, when main calls f1, f1 gives a call to itself. Now, when we say it, we might virtually say that the function gives a call to itself. But the function never gives a call to itself. It gives a call to a copy of its own. So in fact, internally, there is one more copy of f1 which is created. So when I say main with f1, f1 gives a call to f1, it means that it gives a call to its copy. So again, it will consume some memory. So within that, again, if I say f1 is going to call f1, so that will again take up to the one more copy of the same function. So internally, there will be duplicate copies which are created. Logically, on the physical appearance of this particular recursion, we always say that this might end up into infinite operations. And definitely, it is going to consume a lot of memory. Obviously, because when I say a function, if a function is very small in quantity, then keeping a copy of that might not have any overheads. But if the function is very large and keeping that particular function again and again, or recreating that particular function in the memory is definitely a tedious job. So what I need to do is, I need to create copies, reduce overheads, and make this particular process as finite. Because on the physical appearance of this particular example, it never says that it is a finite example. It keeps on doing this particular task again and again. And moreover, the instructions which are written after this are never executed. So it means that whenever we use recursion, I had to have some condition at which the process gets terminated. We call this as a base case condition. Can I say that recursion is used to repeat a set of instructions? Yes. We have heard the same definition in one of the other chapters. We have heard this definition in iterations. In the iterations also, we say that a set of instructions are going to be repeated again and again. Can I say a recursion as an alternate of iterations? Yes, very well. You can very easily say that recursion can be treated as an alternate of any of those looping structures which are used for iterations, while, for, do, while. You can repeat any of those examples of while, for, do, while using these recursions. But definitely, you need to be more logical in this when recursions are used as an alternate of iterations. Is that the only difference between recursion and iterations? We have some more differences. Let's identify some differences of recursion with iterations in this particular example. So here, I have noted some differences of recursion and iterations for you. The very first says that this is a function that is partially defined by itself. Recursion is a function. Recursive function is a function which is partially defined by itself. So it means that this is going to give a call to itself. It has got a definition inside it. It has got a call inside it. But whereas iteration instructions are loop-based instructions. where I'll be using a for loop or a while loop or a do while loop for a repetitive process. Now, the recursion will use selection instructions. Recursion contents of a recursive function will never be a loop. Since I said loop alternate itself is recursion, this function might use if else, or a switch case conditions, but they will never use looping instructions. Whereas iterations, they use repetitive instructions. Infinite recursive occurs. Yes, if recursion is not stopped at a specific condition, if I don't write the base condition proper, then probably your recursion might end up into infinite process. Similarly, an infinite loop can also occur with iterations. If the loop conditions are not written properly, then loop conditions never become false. So in both the cases, there is a possibility that infinite operations are possible only because of the user error. Recursion will always terminate when a base condition occurs, whereas iterations will always terminate when the loop condition turns out as false. Similarly, recursions, when it comes to the execution speed, we say that recursions are much slower because they had to have to create a copy of these functions. When a copy is created, there is a stack of memory which is used. When to traverse back or create that, obviously there is some overhead. Hence, recursion is said to be slower than iterations. When it comes to the memory aspects, recursions, they use more memory as compared to iterations. Because iterations, they operate on a single variable which keeps on incrementing, adding, assigning, all the stuff. Whereas in a recursion, the same copy is created, in that again memory gets added up. So with respect to memory, obviously recursion is much more than iterations. Now, infinite recursion can crash the system. Iterations will quit this particular infinite looping through some hardware keys. If the function is very large in nature and if I use recursion, definitely it will pile up a huge amount of memory. If the memory which is allocated for the compiler, for the application, is limited, in that case, recursion might crash the system. Recursions, when it comes to the length of the code, recursions makes the code much more smaller. Whereas iterations, even though if I use the repetitions, they will have a very, very lengthy code. These are some of the basic differences between a recursion and iteration. So let's wind up with this particular part. What exactly mean by recursion? When a function gives a call to itself, we call the function as recursive function and the process as recursion. Recursion is said to be an alternate for iterations. So in a recursion, we use functions, whereas in iterations, we use looping structures. So in both the cases, you have to write proper base conditions, then only you'll be able to have finite operations. Otherwise, it will have infinite operations. It means that what are the examples which can be carried out using iterations? The same set of examples can be even redone using recursion also. So in the future videos, we'll see how recursion will help us to eliminate a while loop, eliminate a for loop, or eliminate a do while loop. Thank you.